Welcome, and thank you for visiting the Stratton Foundation website. I'm Doug Stratton, president of the Stratton Foundation, and we're here at the home site of Gene Stratton-Porter, an inspiration for our organization. Gene was an author that was born and raised here in Indiana, and in 1913, she moved here to this home site on the shoreline of Sylvan Lake near Rome City, Indiana. If you were coming out to have a visit with Gene, this is what you would have been greeted with, and this would have been your first sight. These owls, these were the birds that were of great interest to Gene and inspiration for her. So I'd like to have you come with me and walk down the road towards her home to visit Gene. Today, the Wildflower Woods Cabin is owned by the state of Indiana, and it's a historic home site. It's open to the public, and visitors can come in and experience who Gene was and what she did and what her significance is and contributions to American literature. When Gene began writing, she really wanted to be taken as a serious naturalist, a nature writer, and she began her career writing articles for outdoor magazines and nature magazines, and she became a regular contributor to these monthly publications. And the publishers began asking her to take photographs of the birds and the nature to illustrate her stories. So she began going out into the marshlands and wetlands and patiently taking these photographs. That eventually led her to writing books such as these that were all based upon nature studies. Now, this is what she really wanted to do, but her publishers began discovering that the public actually liked her novel stories, preferred them, that's where the demand was at. So she began to, in her own words, kind of sugarcoat her nature stories with novels, creating characters based upon people she knew in her life. And these are examples of some of the works. Freckles being one of the first to be published over 100 years ago. And Freckles was a character who was essentially an orphan who had moved into the state of Indiana and was protecting woods owned by a Grand Rapids, Michigan furniture manufacturing company. That was his job, to make sure that people weren't out poaching the valuable timber that was to be used for making furniture. Another very significant one was A Girl of the Limberlost, telling the story of Elnora Comstock and her life growing up in rural Indiana. In many of these stories, you can see references essentially to Gene's own life, how she felt about the world and what was going on, and becoming who you were meant to be. The Keeper of the Bees. This was the last novel to be published by Gene in 1925, and the film was released. For by then, Gene had moved from the Wildflower Woods and was living in California and had started her own film production company to make movies based upon some of her novels. Gene had moved to the Los Angeles area in the early 1920s with her daughter Jeanette and granddaughters, and they began collaborating and making films. By then, Gene was doing very well in her career. She had a home on Santa Catalina Island where she had resided in the summer of 1924, and she was working on finishing writing The Keeper of the Bees. Screenwriting was being done, and production planning for the film was also being done at that time. Amidst all that, she was also working on a new home in Bel Air, and she was literally the first person to buy property in the Bel Air neighborhood of the Los Angeles area and was beginning to make her final plans of moving in there. On December 6th, after having a road trip up into the Redwood area, she was being transported by her chauffeur to a meeting and an event in which the vehicle in which she was riding was unfortunately struck by a streetcar, and Gene died as a result of the injury sustained in that accident. Now, her wish that she'd expressed was that when she died, she wanted to be buried back in her beloved Indiana under an oak tree. But at that time, that wish was not to be fulfilled, and she was buried in a cemetery in the Los Angeles area at the wish of her daughter. Time passed, and eventually her daughter, Jeanette, passed away, and the family decided the time was right to move them back and to complete Jean's wish to be buried in Indiana. So behind me is the mausoleum of Jean Stratton-Porter, who died in 1924. Her daughter, Jeanette, went on and lived until 1977. So mother and daughter are together here eternally at the Wildflower Woods at their mausoleum.